Okay.
I am Dr. Kannan Subramanian. I am a hematologist, also a hemato-oncologist and a trained bone marrow transplant physician. Now if you think, consider a hematologist, he is a person who treats all blood related abnormalities, which could be both cancerous and non-cancerous. So anything to do with blood, hemoglobin going up or down, platelets going up or down, WBC going up or down, will be under my specialty of treatment. So to give an example, if you consider blood diseases related to hemoglobin, so hemoglobin going less can be anemia, which can be due to multiple deficiency disorders like iron or B12, which are non-cancerous, would be treated by mine. And the other kinds of disorders which are cancerous, related to say the WBC, which would be leukemia, and the famous example being Anand. But when you consider leukemia as one of the diseases, you always think of a non-curable condition, which is actually not true. And in today's era, blood cancers is probably one of the most curable malignancies of our time and can be cured by as simple as something like chemotherapy. And sometimes you would require also addition of a bone marrow transplant based on what kind of malignancy that you are having. Okay, and third, there are some other disorders like thalassemia, which is not a cancer but still will need to be treated with cancers for a complete cure. Now thalassemia is a genetic disorder, is associated with low hemoglobin since from the age of almost 3 to 6 months. Otherwise a patient will need lifelong transfusions, which can be cured if you do a transplant, say before the age of at least 5 years, and with good results. This again is a treatment which any hematologist is trained to do. Similarly, there are other bleeding disorders which could be part of hematological problem, where related to some deficiencies of factors in your blood or some cells like the platelet going low, one of the classical examples being dengue, can lead to bleeding issues, and those also will come under the purview of a hematologist for treatment. And many of these diseases do have treatment modalities which may not be cured, but you can control these diseases and you can lead a normal life. Also, blood being really the life of all person, I would also request everybody to be part of blood donations. And also in today's era, along with blood, you can also become donors for stem cells, because we know that all patients do not have donors to go ahead with a bone marrow transplant program, and this can really be helped if you could do your HLA testing, which is the white cell group. And once you know that, you could actually be a donor for a life-saving treatment for a blood cancer patient